Hello, this is the LEGO Creator Propeller plane set, and it is a 3-in-1. And so in this one video, I will be showing you all three of the official builds. First off, this thing is obviously not a propeller plane at all. It's not a plane at all. It's not an aircraft at all. It's a hydroplane. It's a speedboat, basically. A racing boat, and I think it looks great. I like the variants of color. You know, it's not just all red. I like the variance of texture, especially around the engine area. This thing is pretty cool. I like the wing, the proportions of it, and it even has wheels on it that are not too obvious to see. They use the landing gear from the plane that just make it easier to move the thing. So it's got two wheels back there with tires, so it's smooth to move it around. And on the front, they just have one single inverted tile there to help with that. Certainly my favorite part of this build is this engine section. I'm not sure what type of engine they're going for here, but certainly with the giant kind of exhaust looking thing on the back, you know, it could just be a cowling for aerodynamics, but kind of looks like a big exhaust. Kind of looks like the thing is set up to be a turbine back there. But whatever it is, it just looks cool to me. And then the canopy section, you know, this is a creator set. It's not one of the minifig designed, minifig scaled creator sets like the big buildings are. But when I looked at this, I realized that the cockpit looked like it was shaped pretty well for a minifig to fit in there. And when I tried it, guess what? Put that guy right in there. It's perfect. It's perfectly sized for a figure. So this will live happily next to and amongst LEGO City sets and things from other series that are designed for minifigs. Now here's an aircraft build, a very light helicopter, looks very sporty, also looks inspired by a military, like a recon or light attack helicopter design, especially with the winglets there that are usually designed to support equipment like weapons. You can look at it however you want to. Obviously the color scheme is not very military inspired because it's LEGO, but I think this is another one that looks like it could be the primary build easily. It does use quite a lot of the pieces, not all of them, but it's a pretty solid design. Most of it looks very purpose-built, like they chose the parts in this set for this. The most awkward thing about this to me is just this little section of the tail with the Technic holes that show up there, and also the combined axle pin that comes through to the other side there. But what that does is allow you to spin up the kind of simulated tail prop there from the other side. So you can just turn this from back there. It doesn't work very well with just one single finger, but there we go. There we go. Just a little bit awkward to get around it. Sorry about that. Of course, the main rotors are able to spin up, and those spin very nicely. Lots of inertia there. Keeps it going. Interesting thing with the gear here. So it kind of looks like retractable gear. You can bring those up if you want to, but if you do that, it looks awkward how far it leans forward, and it doesn't like to stay that way. So if you try to roll this around, you'll pretty quickly end up causing that to happen. That's no big deal, but I think that just like that is the preferred way to set this one up. And with its canopy, you can open that as well, and looks like it's minifig scaled well enough to me. So a single stick in the center there, and once again, enough room for a minifig. So you could use this as a city style or agents or whatever, again, other, you know, regular brick-based minifig-scaled type of set that you want to imagine it to be. And finally, here's the main front-of-the-box build, the primary build, the twin-engine propeller plane itself. This thing also looks very good. It's a very uncommon configuration of aircraft, actually. Not many aircraft were ever built with a single or even double-seat small cockpit and twin prop engines, but I think the thing does look good. And one thing that I don't like about this one is the position of the tail wheel there. It's kind of in the middle of the fuselage almost. Should have definitely been farther back, but there's just no other place to attach it back there. So we would have had to add on like a plate or something to extend that out. Just a, you know, a little circumstance there, just kind of force their hand on that. But gosh, this is a nice looking thing otherwise. I really appreciate the stripes that are carried through the tail feathers and also the tips of the main wing there. Got a little bit of airfoil shape going on with the main wing also, which is done pretty nicely. And once again, a little bit of detailing around the engines that just adds in a little bit of extra visual interest. So it's not too sleek and it's not too plain. I most particularly appreciate the black and white elements and where they're placed. Just makes the thing look very sporty and lively. Look at that, even on the inside of the engine, you can still see some details there. Kind of looks like some header rails that are set up down below the way it's done. And also with the engine intakes, with those forward facing anti-studs on these, what is that, 1x2x2 brick pieces. Very well chosen with the scoops under there. And you can retract the gear. And they just lean back. Come back to me, focus, come back. Thank you. Just come up under there, and it kind of looks like it's got a little bit of cowling around the side there, you know? And that actually allows you to put it on the ground a little bit more flat, because when the gear are down fully, it does lean the whole thing back. But this just looks a little bit better on display in general. And finally, once again, cockpit opens up, single stick in the center, makes total sense. And got space for your figure. The figure does sit back a little bit, so it doesn't look like he's able to reach all the way forward here if you have him back against the seat. There is the option to push him forward like this. Just take the entire seat, move that forward. Just a different way of doing it. I think that works perfectly fine, but however you choose, it's up to you. I think it's a great looking thing. I think that all three of the models just look good. They're built nicely, and I feel like you just get a really good deal with this set. Lots of options and certainly good pieces that can be used to make many different things. And with the variety of different colors of pieces that are included here, it's easy to kind of maintain that combination of different colors. You know, if everything was trying to be one color on the outside and then they had a different color used for interior pieces, that would force you to continue to use, you know, the same color for the exterior thing of a custom build, and that would limit what you could do and still have it look nice. This little bit of variety here of colors that do go together very well will allow you to do all sorts of different custom things with this. I just think it's a phenomenal set. Very happy with it, and I'm especially happy with the fact that even though it's a larger scale of creator set, you can still use your minifigs with it, and they're still happy to go with them. So let me know what you think about this set, and if you have a favorite between the three official builds, or if you have any thoughts and, you know, just imaginative ideas of other things that could potentially be done with these same sorts of pieces. Thanks so much for watching. Look forward to your comments, and I will be talking to you again very soon.